Whether it's family pics, pet pics, selfies, or pictures from your favorite vacation of all time, yes, that is me in the Shire, storing your photos securely is super important. Whether you're a budding photographer or a regular smartphone camera aficionado, we'll go over some great ways to help you efficiently store your memories for decades to come. Hey everyone, I'm Trisha Hirschberger and you are watching DIY in 5, the show where we make tech tasks simple enough you can do it all in a video under 5 minutes long. Ta-da! Today we are talking about secure and efficient ways to store your photos. Anyone who has a smartphone is probably used to the warning that you're running out of storage, often thanks to your photos and videos that you are storing. Not only do you want that storage freed up on your phone, but you also want to make sure that your memories are safe and well-preserved. So let's do just that. The most important thing you can do to keep your memories safely stored away is invest in reliable storage. This may seem like a no-brainer, but some drives are simply more reliable than others. Read reviews before buying and know that SSDs are more reliable than HDDs. SSDs also work faster than traditional hard drives, so saving time is an additional bonus. If your primary backup is on a PC with a built-in SSD, then your secondary storage option should be an external SSD. They're fast, easy to use, and you can secure them somewhere safe in case something happens to your primary device. Both Kingston's XS2000 and XS1000 external SSDs are the perfect storage devices for both personal and professional backups. Think about what capacity, speed, and durability may be right for your needs. If you do a lot of photography while off-roading or camping, durability may be more important to you. If you need to take and offload many photos over and over, speed of transfer might be a huge benefit. The Kingston XS2000 offers speeds up to 2,000 megabytes per second with USB 3.2 Gen 2x2 and is available in capacities up to 4 terabytes, while the XS1000 offers read speeds up to 1050 megabytes per second and is available in capacities up to 2 terabytes. Another option to consider if you need to store large amounts of data is a RAID system. RAID stands for Redundant Array of Independent Disks. This storage tech combines multiple drives into a single unit, providing protection in case one of the drives fails. Note that RAID systems are more expensive than buying a single SSD, but do offer greater reliability and data protection. Another great tip you'll hear me harp on often, always have a backup. You never know what might happen to your primary storage device. Theft, physical damage, virus, malware, and those moments are the worst. A best practice I like to follow with any important data is the 3-2-1 backup strategy. 3 copies of your data, 2 locally and 1 offsite. It may seem extreme, but it will ensure your data is always backed up. Another best practice to follow is to have scheduled backup times in place, whether it's automated or something you choose to do every so often. If you have a backup drive you haven't updated in 3 years, then it's only as good as your last backup. Another great trick is to create and use your own file naming system. Using a consistent method will help you find and organize your images faster and really help in the long run. One of the Kingston team members here always uses location, date, and subject to easily find photos. When you see the file name Kingston Tech California 10123 Redhead 1, you have a pretty good idea of what that file is without even opening it. Another great way to keep your files organized is through metadata. Metadata is information embedded in the image file and can be used to provide additional context about an image. Things like keywords and tags are hugely useful here, and you can use Adobe Bridge or Google Photos to edit or add metadata. Some software will store some types of metadata outside of a file in a database, which could mean that the metadata could be lost if the file is moved to another location, while others will write the metadata to the file itself. Okay, so 3-2-1 backup with reliable storage or RAID and my own system of file names and metadata written to each file. Got it. My Hobbiton honeymoon is safely stored away so I can hold on to and revisit those memories forever. Whether you are a professional or budding photographer, videographer, or just a whiz with a smartphone camera, I hope today's video helped you out. Feel free to like this video and sub to this channel so you don't miss out on any future tech tips, and I'll see you next time with more DIY in 5.